You went from Oklahoma to Virginia and then to Orlando. Tell us about that.
Yeah, no, I think it's been very, very different. You know, being in Oklahoma and growing up there my entire life, you know, I kind of had known that I was gonna, you know, soccer was gonna take me, you know, all over the place. And then, of course, going to UVA for a year and a half and being able to experience that and, you know, play there, go to school there was, you know, a great experience for me. And then, you know, getting drafted, you know, every person's dream to, you know, start playing professional soccer and playing, you know, playing with Orlando, playing under Oscar, you know, in the great city. And then, you know, the opportunities that that brought, you know, after that, playing with the national team, being able to travel the world and, you know, meet tons of players, people that you, you know, you only saw on TV that you'd look up to. And then, you know, on top of that, you know, being able to, you know, go on loan and play in England, which is, you know, also a dream. So, I mean, you know, just all of that in such a short time, you know, being able to live the dream, you know, it's truly a blessing.
What have you learned under your brief time with Coach Gregg Berhalter?
Yeah, you know, under Gregg, I mean, I think that's, you know, he's been a different coach for me. I think in terms of, you know, my strengths, my abilities, I mean, he sees that. He sees my strengths and my abilities and tries to get the best out of me. And then at the same time, he does a good job of challenging me. He challenges me to, you know, get outside my comfort zone in terms of, you know, maybe learning a different system, learning a new way to play, thinking about, you know, different movements, different tactics. And I think it's great for me. I think it's, you know, something that, you know, every single camp I come to, I learn something and I continue to learn, take it back to what I've, you know, what I learned here, I take it back to the clubs. And I think that's something important to me is, you know, learning the technique, learning the new system, learning the movements. And, you know, he also, you know, recognizes some potential that I have, and you know, he wants to help me. He wants to be a part of that to, you know, help me reach the top level. And I think not even just him, a lot of the coaches, you know, they see that, and you know, they challenge me, and that's the main thing. You know, you always want a coach who will challenge you and push you to the next level.
It's probably something that but we also learned at Barnsley, you know, the run to the promotion league playoffs, playing in England. What was that experience like?
That experience was crazy. I mean, from a young age, I mean, you always watch English football and you always hear about the, you know, the atmosphere, the fans, you know, the competitive play and all that. So being able to, you know, play the entire year and then, of course, get into playoffs and be able to finally play in front of fans with, you know, at Barnsley and then at Swansea and, you know, see the level of competition and, you know, tackles flying in, how the fans are, the atmosphere. I mean, I love it. I think it's great. And I think, you know, for me, that experience was something that, you know, still shaped me, you know, how I was today in terms of, you know, mentally, physically, you know, how I play off the field, on the field, everything. I think, you know, it was a great experience for me. It was really important.
Were you able to adapt to that league, to the culture, which is shocking for you? You didn't think about it. You just went and wanted to play and learn?
Yeah, I think, you know, for me, originally I went over there thinking that this experience was going to be different. It's going to be something that I've never, you know, I've never been exposed to. The, you know, living in a different country by yourself, you know, especially during COVID when everything was, you know, everything was closed and, you know, playing under a different style of play, playing against different types of opponents. And, you know, for me, you know, luckily I had the guys on the team. I think Barnsley, a lot of the staff, you know, they kind of, the coaches and other people, you know, medical staff, everyone around the club, you know, they were helping me, you know, get acclimated to living in England. You know, this place is good, you can go here. Wasn't really much places I could go to, I'm be honest, but you know, like they're helping me around. And then of course on the field, you know, they gave me the instruction, they gave me the tools I needed to kind of be successful and help make an impact on the field. And then of course, you know, going into training, the guys are, you know, giving me a taste of what the game's gonna be like, you know, first training session, getting tackled immediately. And I'm like, okay, so that's how this is gonna be. But, and then learning every single game for me, you know, for personal growth on top of, you know, training every single day, learning from one training and then going into one game, playing Huddersfield, learning, playing Coventry, learning. You know, I think that was kind of the main thing for me is how can I learn in, you know, every situation I'm put in.
There's no clear-cut starter for the coach at the center forward position. How confident are you that you could become the next number nine on the team? Number nine on the team.
No, I think yeah, obviously I had aspirations, and you know, I always say that I want to be the best, and you know, I also recognize the quality of the guys here. I mean, you know, you see the other strikers here, you see, you know, strikers that aren't here, you know, you see Jordan, Josh, and then even then there's, you know, there's tons and tons around, and you know, good competition, and everybody, you know, brings something to the table. And I think for me, of course I want to be playing, of course I want to be starting, but you know, I, you know, go into every single training working as hard as I can, and you know, every single game kind of showing what I can do, and you know, working as hard. And then, you know, when the decision comes to play the game and stuff like that, as long as I kind of prepared myself and put myself in the best position to be able, you know, I'm not gonna can't be upset with whatever happens. I mean, I know there's gonna be quality guys no matter what, and not even just with the national team, no matter where I am, it's always going to be that way.
What do you think about your soccer future? Where do you want to be? You say you want to be the best, so you got to aim for the best teams, for Champions League, for World Cups. Where do you want to be? Where do you want to go? How far do you want to go?
As far as I want to go, I want to, you know, I always say I want to play under the best coaches. I want to play alongside, you know, the best players in the top competitions, like you said, you know, Champions Leagues, World Cups. You know, even in the MLS, you know, getting an MLS Cup, winning competitions. I think, you know, being a competitor like I am, I always want to be involved in competitions, whether it be, you know, with the national team, winning this Gold Cup, winning, you know, Nations League, winning the World Cup at some point. And I think, you know, as long as I keep pushing myself, as long as I keep surrounding myself with these good people, I think, you know, I have the, you know, the right group around me to, you know, achieve those goals in terms of Champions League, World Cup, playing alongside top players, playing at the top level, and enjoying football, enjoying soccer. You know why I play, because I mean, at the end of the day, that's, I wouldn't be playing if I didn't enjoy it. And so that was the main thing, is just making sure I'm also enjoying it, of course.
Well, thank you very much for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming, premium content, and let's not forget as well, ESPN FC 7 days a week. Subscribe to ESPN Plus.